Ciao ciao ragazzi, ciao ciao ciao. So today we're making ragu. So right now I'm cutting the onion. So that is what I'm gonna do right now. What you can use any onion in my opinion, whatever you like, whatever you have. For now, some people use the white onion. I use the onions, everybody have different onions. Oh, so now I put in the sink for easiness. Ciao, 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 ciao Teresa. Ciao Adam. Allora, I hope you have a great, what is today? Thursday. I hope guys you have Thursday. So, like I promised, today I do the ragu. But, now I'm gonna tell you what you need for do the ragu, okay? I'm just cutting this piece. Okay. So, ciao from Tennessee. Ciao, ciao. Ciao, ragazzi. Ciao, India. Ciao. Oh, you make ragu early this week. Ciao, ragazzi. Ciao, ciao. Springfield, where is Homer Simpson from? Yes, ciao Alessio, ricordi il mio commento che ti chiedevo di prepararci il ragù? Bella lì, yes, il ragù è qua. Infatti, I think you aspire, because I need to do this week, because we already finished the ragù, I'm gonna make ragù today, because tonight we're gonna eat pasta ragù, and because I'm gonna take the day to cook the ragù, because right, I need to go later to the doctor just for checking. Jess is gonna stay here, start the ragu. I tell you what we need for do this ragu, and this is not ragu alla bolognese. It's not, okay? So in Italy, they have a lot of kind of the ragus, and this is kind of, I put some touches, my touches here and there, I'm gonna let you know where. All right. First of all, you need meat, and I have two, and this was 1 libra for each. I do a big ragu, okay? Then you need tomato paste. You're gonna use a small quantity, like a spoon. You need pomodoro, mutti. You need at least 2 mutti, and you need 100 tomato puree. I prefer the two. Lately, I discovered the tomato puree. Usually, I was put the San Marzano. This is the San Marzano. This is San Marzano, but already crushed in puree. Before I was doing the actually tomato, I squeeze the tomato inside. I prefer now this. Then you need to prepare your soffritto. Carota. But do you know what? Adding colorful carrots. Usually I do like this, but today I'm gonna put one this carrot. Then you need celery, onion, okay, and garlic. Okay, Italian soffritto. Like I told you in the past, it usually soffritto just for maybe just for the pasta. Using the onion, okay? And you put your tomato. After you keep cook, when the onions come gold, you put your tomato, and then you make your pasta pomodoro, okay? So soffritto. Then for every single house, the Italian soffritto, okay, is another soffritto, this with only onion, but the other thing, it is this one. Onion, celery, a carrot. This is the base for all Italian dishes, okay? Plus, something you never gonna put in the ragu, I'm gonna put rosemary, and I'm gonna put sage. Mamma mia. The herbs, I just love the herbs. So, this, I'm gonna give flavor to the meat. So when I cook the meat, I cut with a little scissors, I cut in small pieces, tak, 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 tak. And usually that is not in regular ragu. But in my opinion, and Jessi's opinion, is making a really good touch. So in the meantime, like always, we're cooking, we're talking, and then when Jessi's coming, come. So I have a big pan. If you don't want to make mad your mom, Italian mom, for make ragu, you need always a tall pan, never a flat. A lot of people, when I came here in the United States, they have the skillet pan, okay? A skillet, like they are tall like this, and they're making the ragu there. No. Ragu never, ever, ever in the skillet. I don't know if it's called skillet, but you know, the pan, flat pan, no. Always with tall pans, okay? So now we're gonna do hard sofrito. Easy. So we're gonna put the pan, we're gonna drizzle oil, and we warm up a little bit the oil. So the quantity, so here it is two, you can put oil and a small piece the butter. Or you don't want butter, and you just do olive oil. Depends how much you like it. Okay, so if you want a little bit of butter make everything beautifully. Okay, and you know what? This time I'm gonna put some butter. I usually doing always olive oil, the sofrito, but I'm gonna put a small piece of butter. I'm gonna take it. Really, really small. Like I put more oil, so I'm gonna it's not even a tablespoon, it is from the measure half tablespoon, a little bit less. In some places they was put all this. At least 2 tablespoons for do the ragu. At least 2 for the quantity. We have a lot of quantity. I'm gonna put this in frigo. So sometimes I throw here some Italian words, so you're gonna learn Italian too. Ad esempio, la cipolla. Adesso taglio la cipolla a pezzettini. Let's see if everybody can understand Italian when we're cooking. So you're gonna be learning and see if you could speak Italian. Allora, adesso tagliamo la cipolla e la facciamo in pezzettini, non troppo piccoli, facciamo una cipolla tagliata abbastanza grossolana, ok? Quindi tagliamo la cipolla così. Non vi preoccupate per le mie dita, perché anche se le taglio, siccome è un ragù di carne, vanno benissimo, ok? E la tagliamo anche da questa parte qua. Allora, così. Ok. So I hope that you understand a little bit. So we don't cut the onion in big pieces, but even no really thin pieces. Just cut the onion like this. It should be all this. Yes. Poi tagliamo il garlic, no, l'aglio, lo tagliamo in pezzettini. Anche qua si può tagliare come si vuole, nel senso ci sono due, allora, it is two schools to make ragu. Who like all the pieces cut thin, che you cannot see nothing, you cannot see the carrots, you don't see nothing. Or it is the other school that they cut everything big because you like to see the colors, you like to see the pieces. And I'm the school, and Jessi is the school for see the pieces. A lot of people doing a lot of small, if you're doing the traditional ragu, you're doing in a really, really small pieces, okay, you cannot see it. Okay, you see just the meat, that's it, and then it's small, that. But I'm gonna even cut in differently, like Yeah, I was here, Jessica. She distracted me. She's laughing with somebody upside. I think the neighbor. I don't know what she's laughing for. She's laughing crazy. I was saying, yeah, we have in the school about cutting in small pieces. And oh, for the meat, I want to just say, usually the meat, it is 50% pork and 50% cow beef. I have just beef because when I try the cow, when I try the pork, no, was good here. Only in Italy, I do the really good. Poi, where is Jesse? Jesse is upside talking with the neighbor, laughing, and like always, I always hear in the kitchen. But then she's gonna work. I'm gonna make work. So I'm gonna put the onion down, okay? Okay, it's cheesing a little bit. So now, for do my sofrito, I'm gonna cut my carrots. So I'm really excited because last time I make the best ragu ever. I never make a ragu like good like that, never. And and we enjoy it so much. And we will. I will try to think about what I did so good because. This is the Italian problem. They don't have a recipe, you know. You just make what you in that day you feel. So maybe one day you put a little bit more than this and more than that. I'm wondering if it was this carrot. I'm wondering if bring something different in the taste. Because I don't know the property if it is sweet carrot. Do you know the property, guys, about this the white carrot? You know, if somebody know, can write down. It is more sweet. It is what? Because the ragu was just amazing. Can see the food. Well, you cannot see it. But it is like I just cutting in pieces. I'm gonna show you now because now I need to do the sofrito. I need to do the sofrito really fast. So I'm gonna cut really fast because every time, guys, can we talking, we mess up something. So gonna. Okay, so I'm gonna show you. Now I'm gonna put immediately the carrots and then I'm gonna show you the pan, okay? Then we cut fast, even the celery. And then I need to see, okay, I did enough celery or I did not too much celery. Then let's see. Allora, ragù. Somebody asking if is the carrots is a from some region because in Naples they don't see it. So I don't know how they make in Naples the ragù. I honest, but il ragù is bolognese. Okay, Bologna did the ragu, and then it's carrot, celery, but it's cut in so small pieces that you cannot see it. So I'm wondering if in Naples they're doing the same thing, like the carrot that you don't see it, because like I said in the beginning, some people cut really small, then with the heat, the hours go like you cannot even see it. Like you can taste it, the flavor, but you cannot see it. And some people they smash it after cooking. They go there, smashing all the carrots inside. And especially when you have kids, because when they see carrots, they said, "Oh no, I don't want a carrot. I don't want this and that." Then you know what they say, you know, what you hate when you're little, you're gonna love when you are older. So now I'm gonna put this. Eccoci qua. And I'm gonna show you the thing, like. Eccoci qua. Soffritto. This is olive wood. Eccoci qua. Because I'm not used to, I would say, oh, it is too white, so it need carrots, but we put 3 carrots, so I leave it like that. Because usually, in that case, I was putting 2 yellow, and then the color is gonna be 30%, 30%, 30%, pretty much. 33% onion, 33% sorry, 33% carrots. But because the carrots, it is white, it's hard to see it by eyes, but I think it's correct. All right, now we make a little bit cooking. I want to put another, my eye tell me, put another carrot, put another carrot, put another, it is carrots. I'm gonna put another one. Small, small, small. Okay. Small and fast. Small and fast. Eccoci qua. Cut. Put everything in the sink, and then then carrots, his favorite, Jessi, so even if it's more carrots, she's gonna appreciate it more, just a little bit. Okay, let's give color. Nah, it's perfect. Now we're waiting the cooking a little bit down, and we're gonna put the meat. It's gonna be easy process. Yeah, carrot, celery, onion, that's it. And garlic. Need to put one piece of the garlic. That is easy. You put your meat. Salt to the meat, you put your herbs, you wait in there cooking. When the meat is cooked, you put your tomatoes. Some people put a little bit of water, and you make there for 3 hours. So now what you want, usually this, it is a 5 minutes, 5-6 minutes. Can you leave the onion and all the vegetables take the flavor with the olive oil, and we put a little bit of butter. And you don't want the fire too high. So in the beginning, for electric stove, I was a 2, and now I'm a 3. Then when you cook your meat, you can go a little bit higher, a little bit, like a 4, something like that. And then you take everything low, like low, the low you can in the stove. Like if we have a gas, you can see just a little bit the flame, and here really low. Eccoci qua. Alessio, ma avete ospiti? È tanto sugo per 2 persone. So we don't have ospiti, so nobody can eat to here. But when I make it, I can freeze it. If I do lasagna, usually this, a lot go with lasagna. And then we are terrible. Me and Jessi, we eat a big lasagna and we eat half already in one night and half the day after. When we're eating ragazzi. We don't take the small portions. But yeah, tonight what I use for the pasta, and then usually I can make four like this. I'm gonna freeze it, and then that is my emergency. Instead to buy the ragu in grocery store like Prego, Reos and stuff like that, that is my emergency. I'm gonna pull out one ragu in the night. I said I do a pasta or whatever, a risotto with ragu. I do like that. That is my emergency food. So, di dove sei? Saluti da Napoli. You are from Naples. I'm from Friuli. So, people was asking, the ragu from Naples, do you use carrots? Because they say a lot of this person go to Naples and they never see the carrots. Do you put the carrots and you just smash it? Like I thinking, or you just don't put carrots? Col ragù potresti, they said to Salvatore, say to make the supplì. Yes, I never tried to do the supplì, Salvatore. Maybe you need to come here to help me. Sei forte, Alessio. Saluti dalla Grecia. Grecia. Ciao, Grecia. Oh, I love your candy here. The waffles, this, every night me and Jessi, we're going to eat it. If you see our video to the candy, Greece came third position, I think. I don't remember, but great. They are good. Okay, yes. So confirm, in Naples, they're doing sofrito like everybody else. You probably, the person who was asking probably find a person can make sofen, and then with the heat and the long time, they go everything like you cannot see nothing. Not liquid, but it is like disappear. Like so they're doing hard sofrito too. I never try Naples from ragu from Naples. I have to try it, ragazzi. I need to come. I need to bring Jessi Naples. I never been either, but I want to try the pizza. They told me to go to Da Michele, but maybe you're going to tell me better. Let me check. All right. The smell, ragazzi. Now I'm going to put my meat. So I'm going to put this and this. Okay. Like we said, I just bought cow because in America, when I tried the meat from the pork, the pig, came off. The ragu came off. I don't know. It is different meat. I don't know. And the meat was from Whole Foods, what the pork. So now I move you with me here. Because now I need to smash the meat once I have one allergy. Okay, so pretty much it's like this. I'm gonna smash in pieces. Like this, and I put salt now, so I'm gonna show you, and now I'm gonna put the salt, fin, and now I put my herbs. So it is the rosemary, and the sage. Okay, I now have just a second. No, and I have the scissor. No scissors. Let me see. With the scissors, it's easy, you know, you cut in small pieces the leaf. And of course, this is already washed, everything. Eh? I prepare everything in the before. I cut the leaves. You never used rosemary, ragazzi? Ciao, Greta. Così. And with this ragu, ragazzi, you can make everything. You make the lasagna. You make whatever you want. And Alessia say anche mia mamma use the rosemary. Even my mom used the rosemary to make the ragu. I think the rosemary in the ragu, it is a big touch. My mom, my dad do it. My mom do occasionally, but she doing sage, but she doing rosemary. It is depend, usually they do it all the time. Long time ago, it's funny, I was peel off the rosemary, I cut in pieces, whatever. Then when I see my dad do with the scissors like this, I tell, you know what? It's much easy. Really, really fast. The smell is already amazing, ragazzi. You don't need too much rosemary. Yeah? You can even do a small piece like this. I put two because when I eat it, I like the herbs. So, and now we just keep moving the meat and cut the meat so the meat can cook. I see my mom leave the meat there and then cook by herself. She have better pan than my pan. Chef, it is a little bit smaller and more tall. So the temperature go really easy to the pan and cook everything evenly. So then, now okay, we finish there. Pepe, so pepper, dov'è?
Non lo so. Non lo so. Oh, it's right there. Let me take the pepe. One second.
Pepe. Let's put a pepe right now. Quantity that you like. So some people put in the end because pepe, the pepper, you with the heat burn out, so non stay. I don't know. I like to put early, but it's like the eggs. Sometimes the eggs you cooking is much better to put in the end, the pepe. Poi. Do you speak Friulano? Sì, speak Friulano. Ci vorrebbe un Chianti, sì. A glass of wine when you're cooking, yeah. Need it, need it. Ah, Che squadra tifi? Inter de Milan? Inter. Quindi chi non tifa Inter sarà, non sarà contento. Does Bucky's make good ragu? I don't think so. I don't think they are that. I don't, they don't make ragu, but I don't think they can make ragu. Hola, do you speak Spanish? Hola, amigo? No. No, I don't speak Spanish. I can understand when I hear some words that are similar, but yeah. Then, ciao Greta, ciao. So, pretty much the ragù, ragazzi, is done. It's done. Now, everything is there. We need a waiting that the meat is cooked, and then we're gonna put our tomato, and then it's done. So, this is the process. So, don't take that much. If you're doing focusing, whatever, die 20 minutes, you're done. It is more waiting the 3 hours and get everything else. I'm gonna put like this. I make meatballs today. Oh, you make meatballs. Nice. Really good. Non sfumi col vino. Bravo. This is a great, 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 great question. Usually, I do vino bianco. Today, I don't have vino bianco. Try to put red wine. I don't think it go red wine. I always saw with... some people say it doesn't matter. You just put some wine. But the wine... It's make a big difference. It's make a big difference. It's coming more good. You're right. Sfumarlo col vino bianco. The question it is, I finish. I never drink white wine, personally, like you do with fish, but like this, I like red wine. So when I buy it, I buy it only for cooking. I buy it. And if a lot of people are asking, which wine, what wine, white wine you need to buy for cooking, the best you can. Much better is the wine, much better it is. That is the thing. Some people buy the cheapest wine, but not because not make good. If you is too pricey, you can make a moderate level the white wine. I always have it, and then I finish it, and I forgot to buy it, so today I go with this without it. But yeah. I'm making chicken marsalas. Do you know how much I'm missing chicken marsala? It's a long time cannot eating. Yeah. Se non c'è, non c'è. Se non c'è il vino, non c'è. If it's not the wine, you cannot do nothing. Time to bake fresh fresh bread. Actually, that you need to do the day before and do in the morning. Usually Jessi doing that. Jessi doing amazing bread. She did a couple of videos here on YouTube how to make it. And she prepared the day before, and then in the morning she wake up, and then we do the bread. And then usually we eating the bread for lunch and then for dinner. Today was a great thing, but because we eat pasta, and let's remove some less carbohydrate in the night. What is my favorite Italian dish? I think I go lasagna, crazy, but I like even fegato con polenta. When I was a kid, fegato, it is liver with polenta. Yeah. Memories when I was a child. Yes, Jessi make the sourdough. She make the sourdough and... is keeping alive from 2020, so 4 years. Oh no, exactly, maybe a June is going to be 4 years the same sourdough. So yeah, we started with the sourdough. We was thinking to try to do a sourdough in Italy and bring it here, but then they told me that with the hair, it's gonna change the flavor from the sourdough. Or the water. I don't remember which one. Polenta and rabbit. Yeah, it was another one. When I was little, and I was happy with the rabbit because it's just bones. And I was kind of not good to eat it. Then when I grew up, I eat it. But it's another dish that we do in North Italy. Yeah. Polenta ragu di cinghiale. You make me want to eat, ragazzi. It's almost 10 years came in the United States. My memories disappear from that dishes. Now, just think about it. You make me cry. Ciao, Svizzera. Ungheria. Which Italian region is the best for food? Hard to know. Every region have specific, but I eat really good. I know that all the regions, so I eat all regions good. But I think at Tuscany I have more meat than the other things. But Tuscany, I was really, really, I never been disappointed in Tuscany. Never been disappointed when I go eat. Oh, I was lucky. Okay, I found the right places, but I've never been disappointed.
I need to keep smashing here. Actually, I need to bring you
close to me because I need to smash. I cannot distract too much. I try to reproduce the same quality. Ragu, or who gonna hear Jessi later? Pasta with cheese tomorrow. Yeah, Tuscany, it is the great place for hunting meat. It's true, they are really good in that. Example, in Tuscany, I never got a nice, good pizza, like average, in my opinion. If you go in Sicily, it is the best food, street food that you can find. So cheap stuff and really good food. I'm gonna change. I'm gonna use this. Yeah. Because like that. So I just cut in small the pieces of the meat. Because after this, we finish to cook the meat and we're gonna put the tomato and then it's done. Another thing, in Italy, I never see somebody smash the meat. I think it's different meat. My mom never smashed it, it came perfectly. Like small pieces was. So then does he like everything? Oh, a dish? Okay. Yes, she dislikes some dishes. So Jessi, she's not for the, like she cannot eat bunny, like polenta bunny. She cannot eat fish, but fish because she have allergies, okay? So we don't judge that. So all dark meats, she's not for it. So she loves cheeses,
So when you have gnocchi with cheese and other things. In my region, you can eat everything, but you eat even weird stuff. Like you can eat hunting stuff. And example, if I see ragu al cinghiale, I go crazy. I need to take it. If she see ragu al cinghiale and she see quattro formaggi, she go crazy for the quattro formaggi. The basic stuff. But the when we met, and I need to say she happy. She like pretty much everything in Italy. Just that dark meat, she don't love it. So I don't force her what she need to eat. If she wanna try, she try a bite, and then she say no, I don't like it. The most cause she love it, and when we going eating to the Alps, when you go to the refugi. And we go there, and then we eat always amazing. Rifugio, ragazzi. If you never eat in a rifugi, go. It is the small houses in the Alpi or Prealpi. Just a little bit all over. And in Friuli, we have it. And she loves all that kind of stuff. It is all homemade, fresh from the place. And at least where we go. Okay, so I think I'm gonna show you how it looks like. I almost finish. Okay, allora. Show you. Guardate qua. Call me crazy, but that is perfection. I leave one more second to the meat finish to cook. It's pretty much finished, but I wanna make sure that all the meat is cooked. And then like this, and then we're gonna put our tomato paste and then the tomato, and then done. Eccoci qua. Let me see some comments, ragazzi. Sì, il rifugio è tanta roba, tanta roba. Best tomatoes are from all southern Italian region. I'm from Puglia and we have some of the best. I'm sure the Calabrian and the Sicilian are top quality as well. Well, yes. In the south, the tomato is perfect because from the climate, it is perfect. And the dirt, it is no argilloso, so it is amazing dirt. The tomato, yes. Then if you see San Marzano, there at the top, always when it's a volcano, and using the volcano dirt or whatever, like in Sicily, the pistachio Bronte, they're using the dirt from the volcano. See the rocks, whatever they make, and they come always the best. Always the best. Now, I don't know where is Mutti come from, if it's from, where is it? But of course, tomatoes, can you grow in tomatoes in the south? I agree with you, and they are always different flavor. Tomatoes and herbs too. You ever eat wild boar ragu? Yes, in Tuscany. I did, and then in my region. Yeah, we're doing. We love vision. As an example, Jessi was like it, but not the favorite. If you put there, she don't go, but I like deer. I mean, when you are from the hunting regions, you grow up with that taste and then you like it. So I guess it is just go used to with the flavors when you are little, you know? The best tomatoes are that ones that you grow. Exactly, are the best. But don't think that the tomatoes that you save it in the glass cannot be the best. Example, the San Marzano, they are the best. They are the best. You can put in the glass and they are on top. But yeah, good tomatoes that you grow, it is always good. If you're doing everything organic, everything right, if you're not living close to the city, then the rain pull down all that chemicals for the city, you know, for the cars or whatever. If you live in that area, yes, definitely. The weirdest dish you eat, huh? The weirdest, I don't think so. I eat snails, but I don't think it was weird. I eat small birds. I eat fagiano, but it's another bird that people eating there. I eat all that. Snails could be maybe what people are. Oh, no, snails, but I like it. Much to say, dop, yeah. So now we're going to put the tomato paste. Quantity, not much. I cannot do it like this. I'll try. Okay. And now, tomato. Andiamo di pomodoro. Oh, it's not coming down. It is a lot of tomato here. I'm gonna put some water and wash so I can. For now, I need to open this. Some people don't use much tomato. Eccoci qua. This can is safe, at least that's what they say. Okay. That's so I'm gonna show you.
Ragù. Abbiamo finito il ragù, pretty much. Now I'm gonna wait that the ragù come warm, but I don't wanna lose this tomato. I'm gonna put some water. Okay. Then I'm gonna wash out later. And then this one too.
I don't use the water from the sink because the water from the sink is terrible. I try to filter.
Eccoci qua. Ragù finito. Now, una mescolata.
I waiting that I'm gonna take some temperature and then I go super low, 3 ore. But my job is done, ragazzi. The job is done. Sotto di mania? Sì. No, di maniago, maniago, ma dalla zona, sì. Sei di maniago sicuramente. Sì, sì. Sei di Montreale. Paola Alzetta. Oh, Madonna. Alzetta è un cognome che so. Ah, sì. Può essere, eh?
Devo andare a vedere.
Ah, sei di Maniago, ok. Aspetta. Che qui magari... I found people I know from the... I mean, I know everybody from Maniago. I know everybody from Montreale, everybody. Depend the year you guys are. I'm 86. So, the year there. But I don't know if you was going to Maniago or Montreale drinking, but of course, Maniago, see, I made tempi. You going to Raul, Bomboniera. You're doing all the bars that you're doing all, if you know what I mean. You're doing all the bars. È così. Ciao from Toronto. Ah, del 2009. Tu sos giovin, and you need to add, you know, boy, tu sos giovin. So Paola, she's young, 21, so yes, but I have 3 brothers, so definitely... If it's one, it is close to 85, 86, something like that, or even younger, 88. Definitely, I know. Definitely, I know. Ciao da Montreal. Sì. E insomma, così, ragazzi. Ah, okay. It is better, right? A Uber, or could you rent a car from an airport, depending which city you go in Italy. So Ubers, I never saw Ubers in Italy. They are, but I never saw it. If you go home, I prefer use taxi because it's more fast. But sometimes I take even the buses because it's the cheapest option. Depend how tired you are. But if you go around the city, I always use the transportation, like buses. If you come from the airport and you're so tired and you want to go home, I always take a taxi. Then, you know, in Rome, there are good and not good taxis there. You need to be careful. It is something is happening right now. So if you arrive in the night, you always need to ask the price. If the price, it is always 50 euros. If they tell you from airport to downtown, if they tell you 70 euros because it's night, no, it's not. I saw a TV show that they was say that they was doing that. Don't do it. It's always 50, even in the night. It's not because it's night you pay more. It's not like, because they try to trick you, because in US it is like that. If you have in busy time, cost you more the Uber, so you're gonna pay maybe 70, but in US, not in Italy, it's always 50 euro, ragazzi. È così. Yes, it is Airport Express, easing and cheaper. If I'm not wrong, the Express is $8 a ticket. $8 per person. So if you have 2 people, $16, you are downtown. But if you have 4 people or you are a family, it's convenient to take a taxi because you pay 50-50. So it is depend everything how many people you are. Be careful on the train. In Tuscany, my friend were
tricked into giving more money or trended bringing arrested. Okay, so in Italy, all the train stations, for us, it is the most dangerous place. When I go in Italy, in my area, wherever, it's nothing dangerous, but in the train stations, some in the big cities, are always people try to rob you, so always watch yourself. They taking the people that they are, like, they see that they are targeted in the face, or they don't pay attention, so they try to trick people there. So always be careful, yeah. What is the best place in Italy to visit? But depend the experience that you want, because in my opinion, Italy is beautiful. All it depend the experience that you want. If you like countryside and you like city, maybe I would use Tuscany, because you can rent a car and go to the Val d'Orcia and everything for the countryside. You can go Siena. You can go a lot of places in Tuscany. You have the beach if you want. If you want just a city vibe, Rome is Rome. Rome is empire. Rome is Rome, ragazzi. If you like have everything, like beaches, you like history, not just Italian history, but Greece history, other histories, Sicily, it is your place. If you want to eat, you want to eat cheap, Sicily is your place. If you want, but I guess even Puglia, it is Naples. If I was going to Naples, I was going to eat the pizza. Then you have the beautiful beaches there. Cinque Terre, it is a lot of hiking. If you want to hike really a lot, Cinque Terre, it is your place. It is just steps up and down. So it's all about experience. But even the Friuli have every region, Piemonte. Depend if you like quiet, you want to live in the small towns. It is. Ciao, Calabria. La Calabria. It's need to go in Calabria. Yeah, the French eat snails. Yeah. They're eating. But they're eating even in Italy, North Italy, they're eating. That areas, North Italy, France, they, Napoleon probably bring the snails.
Okay, here's, I need to put low. And cover.
Now, every 30 minutes, starving. All right, ragazzi, dai. Let's do 2 minutes. 2 minutes before leaving, dai. Where I'm in US now, I'm in Nashville. Ti porto un saluto dal Veneto. Il Veneto. We just been in Veneto. We did Val do Biadine. But I always been in Veneto, me, because... I mean, you go Conegliano, you go drinking there. So, yeah. Yeah, me and Jessi, we are good. Yeah. If I've never been Padova, no. Padova, no. It is one place in... I did Verona. But I know that Padova. Viva il Prosecco, eh sì. But beautiful, Val do Biadine. It is like a place to go. It's feeling Tuscany. Eh? We did a video like, this is not Tuscany. Go see it because it's beautiful. Bene, ragazzi. Dai. So I'm going to finish here because I need to go to the doctor today. I need to go to do the checkup visit. And thank you for staying to do the ragu. Today we non so Jessi. Va bene. Amore, yeah. Vieni a salutare? She's coming to say hi. Dai, vediamo la Jessi.
I'm just watching her video again.
Okay.
Eccola qua.
Oh, ciao ragazzi.
Sei pronto per mangiare il ragù?
Yes, I hope you did just as good as you made the last time.
Yeah, the best ragù ever in the history. No, I don't know. Today with them to do the ragù and...
And I wasn't here, so that means you probably didn't mess up.
Yeah.
Because every time I come in, you always mess up.
I always mess up. So I was say bye because I need to go to the doctor. So
ciao,
you
guys. Ciao, ciao.
So you need to take care of the ragu now. Like you need a star every 30 minutes.
Too much pressure. Too much pressure. I'm going to mess up.
You just go there and think.
Every 30 minutes.
You know, it was two people, one from Maniago and one from Montreal.
Oh, wow. Some neighbors here.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, someone from Murfreesboro.
Yeah, neighbors too.
Everyone.
So Murfreesboro gonna bake Bacchus is official.
No this way.
Kind of, yeah.
When?
I don't know. I read some people comment in YouTube that said it's official they make up Bacchus in
Oh my gosh, yes. I'm so happy.
Yeah.
We need it. We need a Bacchus close by.
Yeah, yeah. Oh. Okay, ragazzi. Ci vediamo. Presto, noi vi salutiamo, alla prossima, che Jessi rovinerà il ragù come sempre.
Ciao guys!
Ciao!